If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, we got the Ultimate Team reveal, new abilities, and tons of stuff to go over, guys. So, of course, we're going to have the two legend pre-guys, like the legend guys who did good in years past on week two. We're going to have the current week two performer, and then we have the LTD past current day player performer as well. So, of course, they revealed the last two last night. I'm going to go over the stats again for you guys real quick before we get into the rest of the stuff. But, again, super exciting that we get four cards now in Team of the Week days. We have the power-up expansion and plenty of other stuff, guys. So, super exciting. Let's go hop into everything. Now, guys, for today's Poodle Squad, if you do want to have a chance to be shouted out in every video, like I keep saying, all you guys got to do is go down below, go to the noti bell next to the sub button, and turn on all notifications for the channel, and just make sure to like the video and comment down below Poodle Squad. Once you do all those things, you are entered to be shouted out in each and every video. Today's Poodle Squad member is Jerry Jeff Williamson. Shout out to you, Jerry Jeff Williamson. That's a tongue twister. For being a part of the Poodle Squad, thank you so much for coming out each and every day and showing support. If you want a chance, like I said, turn on all noties, go down below, hit Poodle Squad, and make sure to like the video. Once you do all those things, you are entered. Now, guys, let's get into the screenshots, go over some of the stats. But, guys, I do want to go over the new gameplay updates that were announced, the new abilities. We got new abilities, run committed, pass committed, and deflator. So, run committed, defender's ability will dominantly win run blocks when they correctly use the guess plan adjustment to break the run. Incorrect guess will result in a loss. Pass committed, defender's ability will win pass blocks when they correctly use the guess play adjustment to predict the pass. And then deflator, defender's ability will cause increased fatigue penalties when tackling the ball carrier with a non-conservative tackle. So, that's actually pretty good for, when running backs are taking big hit sticks, they just get up and keep playing all, and people keep running you down. If you hit stick them, they get deflated, which means they're not going to be as great in the next play and can really throw off another player, so which could really throw off a drive. Now, not a fan of pass committed and run committed. Run committing and pass committing should automatically do this for you when you guess the play, versus it only works if you spend training getting the ability on it. But that's it for the abilities, guys. And then Enforcer, it fixed the issue where hit sticks too frequently result also cause more fumbles. That's about it for that. So we got DaQuell Jackson, middle linebacker for the Cleveland Browns. I'm not entirely sure what week this is for, but here you go. 84 speed, 87 excel, 82 strength, 87 tackle, 87 play rec, 86 block shed, 85 hit power, and 76 zone coverage. Now, this card's decent, kind of slow in my opinion, but of course, powered up and everything can get into an 85, which is kind of like Junior Seau speed territory per se. Now, he does have good hit power. He doesn't have great zone, though. So unless you're leaving him as a run stuffer purely, you probably have to use him. But again, he's a decent run stuffer, but he's not going to be great in the zone over the middle of the field. Good tackle, good blocks, good play rec. He's really well-rounded. I mean, he's not bad. He's decent for his overall. Nothing too crazy. Again, I wish he had like maybe an 85 speed or an 86 speed. But again, not everyone's going to have that top-tier middle linebacker speed because not most middle linebackers are super, super fast. That's not really their role. Not supposed to be speed demons. The ones that are the glitchy ones from Mud, of course, like Bush and Queen and a few others. Now, he looks solid. He doesn't look bad at all. I just wish the zone maybe got to an 80, so you can go ahead and... I mean, you probably can. If you put lockdown on him and you power him up, you could probably get into an 80 zone, which isn't horrible, actually. But it really comes down to whether or not you guys feel as though he is a worthwhile player on your team. Next, guys, we got Marvin Harrison, 89 overall. Kind of weird to see Marvin Harrison as a Team of the Week card. I'm so used to seeing him as a legend. Now, last year, I wasn't a fan of Marvin Harrison because he was very similar to Torrey Holt. But this year, we don't have a Torrey Holt Muttmaster, so... or level of master. So this year we got Marvin Harrison separately. We got him as an 89 overall for the Colts, 90 speed, 89 jumping, 87 catching, 80 catching traffic, 85 spec, 87 short, 88 medium, and 87 deep. Now, phenomenal route runner. Powered up and chemmed up, you can probably get him to a 90 deep route running. You can get him to like an 88 spec catch and a 91 speed. So he's going to be super, super good, super solid. Now his medium and his short won't hit the threshold, because unless you put West Coast or play fake or one of those, but go deep, we'll get him to the deep. So the deep route running plus the 91 speed, guys, is going to be the exact same card just about as Tyreek Hill. Going to be a better catching, better route running Tyreek Hill. So Marvin Harrison's actually super solid, super great. You probably want to be picking him up and, of course, powering him up to give him that 91 speed and getting him to that deep route running threshold. But he is super great. Now, the thing with Marvin Harrison, he's going to be a little lackluster in catching in terms of being hit and then dropping the ball with that 80 catch in traffic. So you have to remember he's going to be more like a Tyreek Hill guy. You're not going to want to be throwing into, contested with him. But he is a speed demon, so you're going to have plenty of use for him regardless. Hey guys, and for today's hero, we do have Dak Prescott. He is this week's hero. Now, again, I told you guys it was going to be Dak or Aaron Jones. Sadly, they didn't give it to Aaron Jones, but like I said, there was a double packer, so the odds were lower. But I didn't want to go with Dak, but everyone else was. But here we go, 80 speed, 87 throw power, 90 short accuracy, 87 medium accuracy, 87 deep accuracy, 86 throw under pressure, 89 throwing the run, and 87 play action. Now, he's one of the most accurate quarterbacks in the game. If you do power him up and go deep, he will hit the deep accuracy threshold. He will get to, like, I believe an 88, 89, or even 90 throw power, depending on what you have. If you have maxed out throw power and powered up, you will get above a 90 throw power. So he's going to be one of the best throwing quarterbacks in the game by far. With great throw under pressure, he's going to get play action threshold potentially and the throw on the run threshold powered up. And 81 speed. Now, his car could be super great, going to get some great abilities. Honestly, this is one of the better DAC cards we've gotten in a while, considering how accurate he is and the fact that he's going to have competitive throw power with, like, Dan Marino and those guys once he's all chemmed up. Obviously, them chemmed up gets more, but as a base card, he's going to get up there for one of the better throw powers in the game, which is always super solid to see, especially out of a Dak Prescott card, because they never really make his cards too great. They always make him more like a noodle arm, medium accuracy, like regular average accuracy with lower speed, so like he's never great at anything, which always sucks. And then for this week's LTD, we do have Mark Andrews, tight end for the Ravens. He must have had a phenomenal week two a while back. 85 speed, which is super great at tight end, 77 strength, 89 catching, 87 catch in traffic, 86 spec, 88 short running, 88 medium route running, and 71 run block. That run block is honestly kind of decent considering Mark Andrews is more of a receiving speed tight end. That's honestly not bad. Now, what stands out to me is going through the route running. So, chemmed up and powered up, which he cannot be powered up, of course. I do not believe he can, which kind of sucks. But chemmed up, he will... Well, if he could have been powered up, he would have gotten all his thresholds. But just chemmed up, he will get a 90 catching. And he will potentially get the medium or short route running, depending on your scheme. So, that's kind of sucks about this Mark Andrews. You can't run go deep with him. You're going to want to run something that gets him shorter medium so he can be super great on those cuts on his route running, which is going to be kind of a challenge for, I guess, many teams to kind of figure out how to fit him in that sense, where you can get all that stuff for him. And then if you go deep, his spec catch won't hit 90, so there's really no point for that for him, per se. But the speed's great. If only he could have been powered up. Now, as we move on more, guys, we can see these are going to be the collectibles, the ones that get the plus one to their power-up, like the power-up expansion guys, which are also super awesome to keep in touch with. So we got Harold Landry, and these aren't going to be the final stats. These are just collectibles for the sets. Aaron Jones is one of them. Marlon Humphrey. Now, if you watch the game, Marlon Humphrey did get a pick, I believe. Harold Landry got the game-winning pick. Aaron Jones had a phenomenal day. We got Khalil Mack, which is kind of awesome that he's getting a plus one to his overall. And CMC, Christian McCaffrey. So let's go check out their stats also, because, again, remember, these are just collectibles. These are the ones that go into the sets. These are the ones that we'll be worrying about just for the sets. And then the stats are going to be more into their power-up that you're going to want to be using. So Harold Landry gets to an 82 overall, 81 finesse move, 77 play rec, 80 injury, 82 pursuit, 79 hit power. Nothing too phenomenal there. Aaron Jones, 84 speed, super slow for a running back, 86 agility, 86 excel, 81 awareness, 83 carry. Now, there's a plus one, I believe, actually, so it's actually going to be an 85 speed, 87 excel, but that's still super, super slow at this point in the game. Next, we got Marlon Humphrey, who will have an 87 speed, 88 excel, 83 awareness, 84 change of direction, 81 agility. Now, card's decent. I mean, the speed could be a little bit better. 87 is decent. I prefer more in the 88 to 90 range at this point in the game. That's not horrible. Then we got Stephon Diggs, which is actually pretty awesome. So he's going to have an 87 speed, 88 excel. Now again, 87 speed is not that fast, but it is pretty cool that he is going to be getting at least a new card. 87 speed is decent. I wouldn't say I'd have it on my team, but it's definitely not the worst speed to be having right now. I mean, I personally wouldn't use it, but I could see the use for it. Especially for all you guys who may or may not run Buffalo Bills theme teams. Khalil Mack gets to 89 overall now. I wish he got to a 90. I wish he was one of the heroes, but again, it's still fine. We got 82 strength, 80 agility, 81 speed, 83 excel, 89 awareness, 88 tackle, 87 jumping, 86 impact blocking, 89 power move, which is great. He will get the threshold down, put pass rush on him. He will get the power move threshold, and he's going to be super fast, which is going to contribute to him being one of the most dominant edge rushers in Madden. His Khalil Mack looks great, of course, as always. Only plus one on his stats, but that's still big because it's plus one plus a power-up. So you're going to get like almost plus two to everything from where he was before as an elite card, which does get into the power move threshold now, which is a big difference because that means you can more than likely get edge threat. And that's kind of what makes or breaks cards these days. So getting edge threat is going to be huge. Khalil Mack's always huge. That's going to be a fun card. And then, of course, we have the CMC power-up to look at here, which is a 90 overall receiving back archetype. So 91 agility is great. 87 speed's low, in my opinion. I don't know if I could really rock with him. He's going to be similar to, like, I guess, Zeke and those guys, but we have 91 speeds. We have 92 speeds. 89 excel, 90 awareness. 80 catching is amazing, actually, for running back. 91 carrying is great. Again, can't truck, not a power back, but the catching is great. I mean, as a receiving back, he's really going to get the job done. You do use him as such, and a running back. I just wish he had, like, give him, like, an 88 speed. Like, give him just plus two speed, and he's in another conversation, but work done day one had an 88 speed, so even that's kind of slower. I really wish they made the McCaffrey a bit better, but overall, these cards are great. We got Dak, we got Mark Andrews, we got Marvin Harrison, And we got one other guy we can't remember right now, but it was good. Honestly, it was a good drop. We didn't get Jamaal Charles, which is weird because Kralo did mention him on stream. So maybe it was for week three because he did have a pretty week three back in like 2009 or something like that. So maybe that's what they're referring to. Who knows? Of course, we'll get into all that. And we do have a title update coming today, guys, and new abilities. So stay tuned for all of that as well. So you guys can go ahead and see that. So the new abilities, I believe, will be in the title update. Won't that be coming out probably close to one or two or directly after this video, depending, of course. But I know you guys be focused on the new Xbox and so on. So hopefully all that comes out in this time slot. Remember, Team of the Week will be coming out sometime between 1 and 2. Maybe it just depends on the delays they have and everything that goes on. But yeah, I mean, I like this. Good Team of the Week drop. Hopefully we do get some more bangers in the future because there's so much potential for this, for like Jamaal Charles, Darrell Revis's, Chris Johnson's. So hopefully we do end up seeing more stuff like that in the near future. But guys, that's about it for the video. Again, if you want a chance to be shouted out in today's Poodle Squad, I think it was Jeff Williamson. If you want a chance to be shouted out in today's Poodle Squad, all you got to do is turn on the noti bell next to the sub button, turn on all notifications, hit the like button, and of course, comment down below Poodle Squad. Once you do all those things, you're entered to be shouted out. Thank you so much for all the recent support, guys. Keep it up. Enjoy today's video. Smash the like button. I'm out. Peace.